Genesis 1:16 tells us that the moon was created by God as a light to rule the night. However, some astronomers have taken God out of the picture and come up with many theories on how the moon could have originated through cosmic evolution. To name a few, the Fission Theory, the Capture Theory, the Nebular Theory, and the most recent, the Giant Collision Theory. In the collision theory, about 4.5 billion years ago, the Earth was struck by a planet-sized object traveling at an estimated 25,000 miles per hour. This massive collision caused debris to be thrown into Earth's orbit, and over a period of time, this debris gathered and formed itself into a single moon. Besides its contradictions with the biblical account, there's one major problem with that theory. This is known as the Roche Limit. Edouard Roche, a French astronomer, studied the effects of gravity on moons. He discovered that mathematically, a large object that was too close to a planet would be broken into pieces. As the result of this Roche limit, some scientists believe that the theorized Mars-sized object of the collision theory could not have reached the Earth without being shattered into pieces, and according to Dr. Donald DeYoung, perhaps even forming a Saturn-like ring around the Earth. Despite the attempts of secular scientists to explain the origin of the moon, each one has been replaced over time with a new evolutionary theory. One day, perhaps they'll learn that the Bible was correct after all. I'm David Rives. Truly, the heavens declare the glory of God.
David Rives Ministries presents The Heavens Declare the Glory of God, an exciting one-hour DVD. Now available in the WorldNet Daily Superstore. By way of deep sky photography and common sense terminology, the mysteries of the universe unfold in a manner that is easily understood. Great things past finding out, yea, and wonders without number.